I'm Brittany Miles. I'm originally from the LA area, and I'm an astronomer who's a postdoc at the University of Arizona. I graduated in spring with my PhD, and now I'm a research scientist. Basically, brown dwarfs are just hydrogen spheres, and they happen to be cold enough where they don't fuse hydrogen like stars. They form whatever heat they have, and they just cool off over time. But what's really cool about these brown dwarfs is that they have molecular features due to water, methane, ammonia in their atmospheres. The temperature range of known brown dwarfs is so wide, it fills in the gaps between the smallest stars and planets like Jupiter. So we study the atmospheres of brown dwarfs to understand what do the atmospheres of gas giant exoplanets look like before we have to spend the time to like look for those planets and reduce data. So far I've had the privilege of studying a brown dwarf called VHS-1256b. It's very similar to the HR8799 planets, but because it's very far away from its host star, we don't have to take out the starlight to see all its beautiful molecular lines. And so I've taken a spectrum of VHS-1256b from 1 to 28 microns. And so that wavelength range is double the extent of anything we've been able to do from the ground and space. And so with that spectrum, I can tell you the luminosity of the object. That tells you, you know, how it aged over time. The spectra tells you, you know, what kind of surface gravity does the brown dwarf have. And it just shows all these molecular features that tells you the composition of the object. I've had the privilege of reducing the data to get the best and most complete spectrum of a brown dwarf we know. I'm making a prediction, it's hard to tell, but I think if the TAC is willing to spend time, I think you can detect deuterium. And that's a big signature on, like, you know, deuterium tells you if something is below 13 Jupiter masses and if it's a planetary sized object. It also tells you how far something may have formed from a host star. So if we can detect deuterated molecules, I think that's a big help for understanding, putting those other molecular lines in context of formation. Caroline Morley wrote a paper about that and how much time it takes to find deuterated molecules with JWST. And if someone spends the time, I think that would be the biggest thing in exoplanets to me. I think we're just gonna be surprised. I'm excited to see what my colleagues do and what we learn. I'm really curious to see how much we can actually eke out on directly imaged exoplanets, because the telescope is obviously performing better than we expected. And so I'm gonna be an open book to see what we discover. I'm excited to see how we're proven wrong too. You know, what assumption have we been holding all these years with brown dwarfs and planets, and will that be broken with extra wavelength coverage with JWST too?